top off of all this stuff. Nothing major. I'm not sure if you can see the lines out there or not, but I'm gonna get started. Part of the video, you can see that all I'm trying to do is take 2 or 3 inches off. Normally what you'd be doing is just scraping the sod off, but you clearly see that this really is just a weedy area and not grass. So I'm just trying to cut the top layer off so that we can get the plastic down and then put a little bit of stone in there. And it didn't take very long. It only took probably 30 minutes or so to cut this out. And then started to move to the stone part. Really wasn't a big deal at all. As you can see there, I was having some camera issues this video. Kept falling all over the place and then tried editing it out and then got tired of trying to fiddle with it, so I just left it in there. But it was just a lot of little scraping, moving around, getting it out of there. Doing with the dirt is I was building it up on the right there just a little bit because it was really low over there, so I figured we could use a little bit. And then the owner asked us to just pile it up in the weeds on the left somewhere, but we put it behind me because we thought the skid loader was going to rut up the yard real bad, but it really didn't. All it did was fold down the grass and it didn't make anything squish too bad, so we just pushed it off at the end, but I didn't catch any of that. And this was before I was going to put it in that back corner, but then Scott told me to put it behind me for later that we didn't end up using. ran into right here. I saw this wire at the corner of my eye, and I couldn't figure out what it was, but I think it was a dog fence. And by some miracle, it didn't rip, either by hitting it with the machine or when I was tugging on it, which I was pretty impressed. It was a pretty strong wire. And it stayed there. We just put it underneath the stone because we weren't sure if the owner used it or not, but no big deal. So you can see I climbed up into the skid loader here and was starting to move the stone, and we got the plastic laid down. It laid in there nicely, and all I'm doing is trying to get the stone in there a few inches high. We only used about 8 tons or so, and we'll see when I go to scoop it. I'm not getting full scoops because I don't want to get stone all over the yard. Kind of just push in there, like you're gonna take a full scoop and then back out of it and then flick it up. And if you look in the corners of the bucket, you can see it's not heaped up there, but it keeps the yard a lot nicer. That way it's less cleanup work. And it only took probably about, I don't know, 20 minutes or so to get all the stone carted over here, and then we did go and get it on grade with a laser and going around, but I didn't catch any of that. And we got it pretty close. I got it within an inch and a half or less, or maybe 2 inches, I don't know, with the skid loader just by eye. And it only took a little bit of rake, and it wasn't too bad at all. But I didn't catch any of that because that's not that interesting. can also see as I'm doing this is that I'm only going straight at it. You can't turn on that plastic because you'll crinkle it all up and it'll come out everywhere. It won't stay flat, so you gotta go straight in where you want or sideways to get into the corners. That's why also by that dirt pile I didn't do a very good job, because I didn't want to turn on that and cause any wrinkles for the plastic to come up, which is a pain. Then that just usually leads to a mess. It's like when you're doing driveways and you get into the fabric, the road fabric. There's really no going back. You're just going to have to let it rip. And you don't have any fabric there, and it's a pain in the butt. Wasn't a huge deal on this, obviously, because it's really small. What you can do to negate that is pin it down. That helps a lot, but I think with the type of plastic that this was, pinning it down wasn't going to do a whole lot. And I think the only reason he used plastic on this is because it is a wet area, and I just don't think he wanted the stone to fall into the dirt and get all mixed in and smashed it over time. What's going on here is a prefab shed, to my knowledge.